Castleford Tigers. He's schemed and battled his way all year to get here. There he is, and he's talking now to Rod Studd.
Terry, is there a certain similarity with last season where your Super League status depends on 80 minutes of rugby league?
Oh, it is in that point, but you know, it is a little bit different. We're certainly a lot healthier this year, and yeah, we're looking forward to the game. Two really good teams. They've been the best two teams all year and deserve a grand finalist.
You've shared the four matches so far this season, but from the outside it appears that you've timed your run a little better than Widnes. Is that fair to say?
I'll tell you after the game. I'd like to think so, yeah, but you know, they're going to bounce back from their last performance against us. There's no doubt about that, but we've had 2 weeks to work on some things that we need to get better at as well. And the crowd have come out in force today, and you can't get excited about the day you shouldn't be playing.
I just saw you having a quick word with David Hobbs, who's just won the NL2 final with Featherstone. What were you saying?
Oh, congratulations, you know. He's worked long and hard for that, so, you know, they go up one division, and hopefully we can do the same.
Yeah, hopefully you won't be playing them next season.
I'm sure they would like us to be, because they get some money from the gates and all that, and the rivalry is magnificent, but that's not in the plans.
Good luck, Terry.
Thank you.
It's a massive day for Terry Matteson. I remember his face 12 months ago when Castleford took the drop from Super League, and he actually had to dig deep into his own soul that day and say that he would stay with Castleford and guide them back to Super League. He's done that, and well, who knows what the next 80 minutes has in store for him. Widnes Vikings are the opposition, of course. Steve McCormack has been down this path many times before. He has never won a grand final. I wonder if he wants to get that monkey off his back. He's with Rod.
As you said, Steve has been here many times before, three times before, Steve, and not got the right result. Are you due one?
Well, I certainly hope so. Yeah, like I said, I've been privileged to be involved in three finals previously, but you know, these days are not about losing, it's all about winning, and hopefully you know, the players are pretty focused there. Hopefully they'll do it.
Has that experience helped you and the Widnes team from last year's game against Hull KR?
Yeah, you'd like to think so. There's only, you know, we'll soon find out, obviously, when kick-off time comes, but there's quite a few players what were involved in last year's final, so you know, you get experience from doing that, you get experience through winning, you get experience through losing, and we've won a Northern Rails Cup final as well this year, and you know, that was a fantastic feeling, and hopefully we'll do the same this week.
That was a big peak, that Northern Rail Cup final, and that victory over Whitehaven. Has your form not been quite as good since then, though?
Well, we're here, aren't we, so it can't be that bad, the form. You know, you've got two good teams in the final. Castleford's been great. We've earned the right to be here as well, and it gives him with a chance.
All the best, Steve.
Thanks a lot.
Well, a big day for Widnes as well. Of course, they were in the grand final last year and they fell short. There were two big reasons why they fell short. And here they are.
That's a bit
unfair.
It's a bit
cruel. Holy moly. I was only on for a while.
You were both at this stage, albeit at Warrington last year. You know what is now going through the minds of the players preparing for this.
Well, Steve McCormack's just said that it's definitely not a place to come and lose, and to get there, to get to just the, in clinching distance of getting to Super League and just failing at the last hurdle, it's a shocking place to lose in big games when there's silverware on show, but especially when there's Super League there. All these players want to test themselves week in, week out of Super League.
I've called this from the very first time we came on air today at 3 o'clock. I've called it the £1 million match. It's probably a little bit more than that these days, isn't it? But it's a massive, massive game for all concerned.
Super League has brought rugby league onto a different level, and we've been going for 12 years at it now, and we just keep getting better every single year. And what it has done is it's made those 12 clubs the absolute creme de la creme, but unfortunately for everybody behind them, they're just striving to get into that. Widnes has been a great club in the past. You know, Castleford has been a great club in the past, and even Featherstone and Oldham have been great clubs in the past. So everybody wants to get there, and this is the stage where you guarantee that position.
Well, the two sides have battled their way through to get here, haven't they? It's been a real effort from both Castleford and Widnes to get here so far. There's a little bit of history between the two clubs, of course, this year. Where do you think this game, fellas, is going to be won or lost?
It's just so close, isn't it? To call this game, like Widnes have the key players like Dennis Ram, Mark Smith, Bob Bezett that can just turn the game with Gricks. Both teams have got really good back threes who return the ball very well. But Castleford have got stars with Brough and Thackeray. It's very close, and it is literally two games each. They both won two games each this year, and it's in the balance who can win it. Who's going to turn up on the day to play the game? This is the lad who I think, Thackeray. He just runs across, he starts looking for the drop-offs. Again, he runs across for the drop-offs. He looks to it. It's a lead player going through the gap. But then as he keeps on doing it, he starts showing the ball and going himself. And he's got great speed to go on there and do that. But as well, Danny Brough, look at this for a kick. Straight downfield, inch perfect. If there's anyone that's going to kick a ball and hold it up like this, it's Danny Brough. And the kick chase, again, just changes tempo of his running, puts a ball in for Joe Westerman to score a try. And then again, big long ball on the left-hand side. That is Danny Brough's big play. Always works that left-hand side. But Mark Leafer, big, aggressive forward, and Ollie Wilkes there, he's going to lead some aggression today from the for the Castleford side, going to take it to him all day. As well, the offload always gets his arm free, always looks for the offload every time he goes into collision. And technique in defence, very good. Dominates players constantly. Now, this was in the semi-final where Castleford played Widnes, and this, I thought, was a big turning point, because the way that Widnes celebrate here, I thought that they just forgot to play the game. Straight from the kickoff, they forgot to play. Whereas Castleford just got straight back into the game, and they just done what they'd done from minute one right to the end. They didn't panic, and they just got on with the game. And that's where I think the big turning point came in that game.
You mentioned Danny Brough there, Terry. He is already in Super League, come what may today. Danny Brough has signed for Wakefield. I just wonder about the desire of the players out there today, if they've already agreed and signed on the dotted line for a club for next year.
But because of the situation is where you don't know whether you're getting in Super League until today.
Oh, I can understand
players,
that.
Players from both sides that won't be announced yet have already signed to go on elsewhere. So you can't question the players. Oh, you get to a grand final,
does that play a part in the
preparation? When you get to a grand final, you want to win. Danny Brough will want to go out winning today and guiding Castleford back into Super League, as will any player who leaves either side.
Okay, well, Barry, I know you've been looking at the Widnes players. Who do you think are the key men for the Vikings today?
Obviously, the back three for Widnes are integral to what they do. Griggs, Dodd, Blanche, very, very prolific with the ball in their hand, but the strike comes from people like Dennis Moran, and on this occasion, he weighs up the situation. It's a tremendous skill to have in your armoury, and Dennis Moran feeds another good performer for Widnes, Mark Smith, and both Smith and Griggs marshal that middle channel, and they're there picking up the scraps. But any team is only as good as its forward momentum. Mick Cassidy does it very well, but this guy for me has been consistently the top performer in the front row position of any team all year, and the way he jams that ball up, the way he takes it upon himself to start the ball rolling, to get Widnes in the good positions. Ollie Wilkes and Mick Cassidy in spells, you know, they need to start that momentum.
It's the 10th National League Grand Final we're going to see here today. Both of these clubs have been in them before. Widnes third, Castleford second, and they're both looking to win at this level for a second time to get back into the Super League. Does recent history play much in what's going to happen here?
No, it doesn't matter who's done it before. It doesn't matter who's won two games. You know, it's absolutely square. It's hard to say where the breaks are going to come from. Defensively, unlike the two previous games that we've seen, we'll see players that are conditioned to play in the chess game. Players that are conditioned to being very, very patient. And I think probably the two games that we've watched have come off good play and not so much mistakes.
OK, Phil, of course, has been here with me in the studio throughout the course of this afternoon until now. He's made his way across to the commentary box. And Phil also has one or two thoughts on who might be the key men here today.
That's right, Eddie, yeah. The most common way of receiving the ball is when your opponents kick it deep downfield to you. And Stuart Donlan, as fullback for Castleford, has a big responsibility on his shoulders. But with almost 300 career appearances behind him, you know, he was selected for Lancashire 5 years ago, he brings a lot of experience as well to this side. He brings a try-score importance with 20 already in 2007, and I think probably most importantly for his teammates today, he brings big game experience. He actually played for Huddersfield in last year's Challenge Cup final, and I think that experience from the big occasion can sometimes settle the teammates around him. Opposite him, well, one of the most exciting players, I think, in this division, Scott Griggs, is sensational, and we've seen him at his best at times this year. As you see, named in the Team of the Year for this division, he scored 21 tries already. And, you know, he was sensational in the Northern Rail Cup final we saw back earlier this year in Blackpool. Both of these players are so important to the sides. As I say, it's the most common way of receiving the ball. And I guess when they kick the ball to each team's fullback, they'll be hoping that the chasers can put them under pressure, because in broken field play, both have speed and, I think more importantly, vision to create for themselves and their teammates, Eddie.
So the fullbacks, maybe they have the key. I think the coaches will hope that anyone from 1 to 17 will have the key. What about the coaches? I mean, Terry Matteson, as I said, it's a massive decision for him to stay at the end of last year after all the disappointment.
If I'm right in with my memory, I think that he'd actually said if he lost the game and got relegated, he will actually leave the club. But the club persuaded him to stay, and he's done an excellent job with them this year. And speaking to some players inside, they really enjoy the style of coaching that he has. He's a tremendous character. Andy Hay, who stood at the side of him on the right there, a guy who I spent some time with at Leeds, he'll give his benefit, or the benefit of his experience. And again, they're just a well-rounded side. It's hard to pick one individual player from Castleford because they're very well-rounded.
We're going into this game and coached by Steve McCormack. Widnes have got probably the coach, the most experienced coach, going into the National League Grand Finals, haven't they?
Well, they have, but they also got the coach with the worst record in National League One Grand
He may have had the worst record, but he might learn from his mistakes, from his build-up during the weeks from the first couple of games that he was up at Whitehaven, and more relaxing and relaxing the players, because you do look for the influence off your coach, not leading up to the big games, to steady the ship, really, and you want your senior professional players to have that calm and influence, like Phil was saying, and going into a big game. The Widnes players have done that last year. A lot of these players played in the Grand Final last year and playing against the Castleford side who are relegated, who want to prove a point and get back to Super League. It's going to be a great tussle.
And Steve has got the monkey off his back a little bit, hasn't he, with that Northern Rail Cup final success against Whitehaven in July. What was it, 54 points to 6, wasn't it? A massive win. We're not going to see that today, are we?
No, I wouldn't think so. Again, I look at the playoffs and the Super League playoffs, they've been absolutely fantastic, but they've been ever so tight, and I think this is going to be something of the same ilk, because lots of people in and around the area think that these two sides could quite comfortably cut it in Super League. So that mentality, there we see Steve with his lad at the side of him, both Wigan Athletic fanatics they are.
He always gives him a bit of a team talking and tells his dad how he wants him to play.
Is that right?
But it's great. It's great. He's a real family man, and he's done it. He's done it tough. He's not had it all his own way, Steve. Like last year, like with the team itself come under some criticism at Widnes, and Steve stuck through it, stuck with the players, and again this year, and he's just built on it, and the players respect him as they do Terry Matteson. So you're going to see two teams going out there fighting like cat and dog to just come up with that result.
I just wonder, you know, we talk about how successful or how big it is for the successful club here today. Whoever gets there will get to Super League, whoever wins. Yeah. How big is it for the team that
exactly.
loses?
That's
where
the other
do they
we
go?
Well, I'm telling you, if they don't get, there's been massive gambles in Widnes, certainly, that's what we've heard. You know, it's dire for the team that doesn't get there.
There's clubs that, like, the clubs have banked that much on getting back up to Super League this year, Castleford and Widnes, and the rumours around like that Widnes need to get back up. If Widnes don't get back up today, there could be problems, and there definitely won't be a full-time squad next year.
Is that what you've heard?
Well, this is what
you live in the town.
This is what I've been hearing in the town, and it'll be very sad. And so Widnes have got a big chance today. We know it goes to franchise in 2009, but you've got to have your off-field product right as well as your on-field product. So both Castleford and Widnes know really the best chance of getting Super League, and the easiest chance of really getting Super League and progressing, is by winning today.
But then, if they get there today, they then have to consolidate, and they have to have a successful franchise application the middle of next year to make sure that they're there in 2009. It is a massive, massive game that we've got coming up for you here. The Tigers against the Vikings. As the boys have been saying, a lot of people within the game believe that Widnes and Castleford should be in the Super League anyway, and that maybe the competition should be up to 14 teams. That's a decision for the people who run this great sport. But at the moment, it's just 80 minutes that separates Widnes Vikings and Castleford Tigers from the place in Super League next year. Headingley is just about going to be packed to the rafters, because all the other supporters of all the other teams who have been here since 1 o'clock have stayed for the big one. It's Castleford Widnes next. First game of the National League season, way, way back on Friday the 9th of February. A Widnes Castleford National League One Grand Final was always the likely scenario, and so it has proved. These two great rivals are clashing for the fifth time of the season at the Headingley Stadium. Honours are even, two wins apiece. Castleford have won the last two, including the playoff clash at the Jungle just a fortnight ago. Widnes won the opening two encounters, and included in that a Northern Rail Cup semi-final at the Halton Stadium. But here at the Headingley Stadium today, stakes could not be higher. Castleford finished top, so let's take a look at their team first of all. Donlan at fullback, Williams, Shenton, McGoldrick and Dixon, Thackeray and Brough. Forwards, Higgins, Henderson who's the skipper, Guttenbeel, Westerman, Clayton and Lupton. And the substitutes, Liafa, Charles, Wainwright and Boyle. And the coach, Terry Matteson. Now the Vikings, Grix at fullback, Blanche, Coelove, Nanin and Dodd, Moran and Penny. The forwards, Cassidy, Smith who's the skipper, Wilkes, Tompkins, Noon and Bezic. And the interchange bench for the Widnes Vikings. It looks like this. Aaron Summers, Jordan James, Ian Webster and Lee Duran. And the coach is Steve McCormack, who is playing in his fourth National League One Grand Final, and he has never won one yet. Believe, say the Widnes Vikings supporters, for the Castleford Tigers fans, they probably, looking around the ground, they probably do outnumber them. But we shall see. It's going to be quite a battle, this. If the previous games this season have been anything to go by, we could be in for a classic. Two teams that would grace the Super League in their own right, but tonight, only one of them will get to the promised land. Castleford relegated last year. Widnes relegated the year before. The stakes could not be higher here tonight. That's why we have a full house at Headingley to see this battle royal. They're all in good humour. We have had the appetizer, we've had the hors d'oeuvre, and now we're ready for the main course. Teams are waiting in the tunnel, they're making their way and completing their preparations in the dressing room. They both fared well in Monday's National League Awards night. Dennis Moran took the Player of the Year award, Castleman's Joe Westerman was the Young Player of the Year, and Danny Brough took the Players' Player of the Year. Here they come, they enter this cauldron. It was Leeds and Wigan on Friday night here for a place in the Super League Grand Final. The atmosphere tonight is just as intense. Welcome to the £1 million game. Who's going to get to Super League next year? Castleford Tigers or Widnes Vikings? Barry and Terry and Phil are alongside your commentator this season in National League, Bill Arthur.
There is Danny Brough, and there are the massed ranks of the Tigers supporters, and they are here in numbers. I tell you what, they were queuing outside the ground, they have been all afternoon. Phil Bentham, the referee in charge of this crucial game. Might be a £1 million game, but there is more at stake. Franchises round the corner, so a place in Super League holds an awful lot at stake for these two sides. It's going to be the Castleford Tigers who'll get us underway. Brough with the first kick of the game, Widnes in receipt in their own in-goal area, and they were queuing up for that one, and Oliver Wilkes will charge the ball forwards for the first time. The fifth meeting between these two sides this season, the honours are even, but I'm sure what both coaches have said, Phil, that that will have no bearing on this one.
No, it's not. It's all about taking your opportunity. You know, if you look back over the last 5 years, there have been never less than seven tries scored in this game, and I think that the thing that the successful teams have learned is that when you get the opportunity to put points on the board, be it through a drop goal, a goal kick, or even a try, you need to take it.
There is Mick Cassidy taking the ball out, and a late doubt for Widnes about Cassidy's fitness. It was dependent on how he came through the warm-up. He came through OK. So Adam Sidlow, who was on standby to come into the 17, was stood down. But I'm just wondering how Cassidy is going to get through this game. But he is a tough competitor, an old war horse if ever there was one. And here is Danny Williams for the Tigers. He was here at Headingley on Friday night, Williams, watching his former club Leeds Rhinos go through to the grand final against Wigan Warriors. Now he's looking to get there himself. Cassidy involved, high shot on Aaron Guttenbeel, first penalty of the game.
And there you see the high tackle, Cassidy's gone in, it's a swing offers Casavant near the first opportunity to put some points on the board.
Well, he's a seasoned campaigner, Mick Cassidy, knows what his big games are all about. Okay, lads. 34 years old, and that high tackle presenting Castleford with the first opportunity to get points on the board. Bruff it is.
You know, it's okay, often lads, an indication of nerves, even early in a game, from a player with the experience of Mick Cassidy. Just nervous. You want to get an early feel of the ball, be it in attack or defence. Once you get that underway, and if you do that successfully, you can relax someone.
Bruff then from about 35 metres out via the post, first points on the board. Castleford, the vital first strike, 2 points to nil ahead. See what I mean? There are so many here, the south stand absolutely heaving, and they're still coming in.
The lead shot here on Friday night. Just how important it is to start in big games well. They had a penalty, they got downfield, they won the field position, they dominated possession. And it's Widnes kicking off, an attempt to put pressure now on the Tigers.
Both of these teams, the coaches would have gone in and stressed to the players that don't give the penalties away, because in Mick Nanning from Widnes and Danny Brough from Casford, they've got players that if they get a penalty in the opposition's half, they'll have a go at goal.
Liam Higgins now driving that ball forward for the Castleford Tigers and running into some strong defence led by Bob Bezic. Paul Noon in there as well. Now Brough, now McGoldrick, and some discussion among the Tigers supporters about this change that Terry Maddison, the coach, has made, with McGoldrick restored to the starting lineup for the first time in several weeks. Michael Wainwright being demoted to the bench, but Terry Maddison going for McGoldrick's experience and defensive solidness, I imagine. Now here is former Tiger Damien Blanche.
That's a dilemma, isn't it? When you kick the ball, do you kick to the wingers or do you kick to the fullback? There is Griggs, the fullback for Widnes. He's dangerous when he returns the ball, but so are both wingers. Then Bezic just skips out of the acting half-back area. I think in the first 5 or 10 minutes, we'll just see all the players wanting to get a touch and wanting to get their team going forward. Play straight is the message.
Joel Tompkins takes the ball forward, joined Widnes in mid-season from the Wigan Warriors. Cassidy now. Well, if there was a doubt about his fitness, he's certainly started strongly. Now Dennis Moran, award winner on Tuesday night at the National League's night. Can he be a winner here today? Well, what courage from Donlan there. And Toa Coe Love let him know he was around as well.
Well, so second penalty now that they've conceded. It's obvious with the high kick from Dennis Moran that they want to contest all of the kicks whenever possible. And if you get into that sort of position of the field, why wouldn't you put it up? But again, now second mistake, Coyle off, too high on Williams. The team that gets most penalties very often goes on to win in the big matches, and it's 2-0 to Casford at present.
Here is Owen Guttenbeel, a grand finalist, twice with the New Zealand Warriors, a grand final winner. He knows what it's all about, Guttenbeel. Higgins now takes... beg your pardon, it was Higgins taking the tackle. Now here's Joe Westerman. Terry Maddison also knows about winning grand finals in the NRL. But this is the one he wants today. Lupton plays the ball. The Tigers on the attack. Thackeray. Oh, lovely little dummy. Lovely step. Almost there. And he is there. But Phil Bentham will want to see him. Have a video ref have a look at that one.
Here, can you check for me?
Whether he got that ball down, I thought they got him wrapped up, but he just kept going, the number six for the Casavant Tigers.
Well, we've seen Denny McGuire drifting across the field very often here for Leeds. This time it's Thackeray from Casavant coming across, looking for the support on the inside, eventually forcing his way over the line. But does Griggs take the ball from him? Does he prevent it from being grounded?
I think he does. Yes. Thackeray hasn't even got the ball in his hands.
Now, this is where very often the referee would award a penalty, saying 2 men in the tackle, penalty for stripping the ball. But I don't think that that can be the case in a try-scoring position like this, because you would then automatically say to the attacking player, well, you can just release the ball, you'll receive a penalty. He's going for a try, it's quite clear, and he has lost possession. In my eyes, this has to be no try, and Widnes should somehow start the game again here with the ball.
Stephen Smith, the video ref, having a look at that one then. the Widnes get possession, the Castleford get the penalty.
Do you know what? I think it could be a penalty here, Phil. He stole the ball, There was two men in field there.
But the defender, Terry, has to contest the ball.
He stole the ball in field of play. So it won't be,
He's allowed, I think he's allowed to stop the player from grounding the ball, but he can't purposely take the
Ian Smith is the video ref. What's the decision? Has Thackeray got the first try of the game? No. But he has got the penalty.
But do you know as well there, no? Danny Brough's going to go for goal. That is Thackeray's big player. Steve McCormick will have been telling his players time after time what he does. And no, the save is stolen infield, and that's why he's been awarded the penalty.
Harsh decision.
I think that in the off-season, the coaches and the officials and the people who come up with the interpretation to advise the referees and officials on how to handle that situation. Otherwise, you will see in future years the attacking ball carrier simply releasing the ball when he gets near to the try line.
To Brough with another formality. Two more points. Castleford Tigers ahead by 4 points to nil. And Danny Brough with 118 points, 118 goals to his name this season. He might be leaving the club, but he's doing his bit in his farewell game.
Well, the reason why it's 4 points nil on the scoreboard is that it's three penalties to nil on the stat sheet. Those penalties are undoubtedly the reason why Widnes have been near to their own line and have given away the opportunity for Danny Brough to get his team off to a pretty happy start.
Steve McCormack has seen it all before. This is fourth grand final, yet to win one. He knows the highs and lows, and a lot about the lows, but won the Northern Rail Cup this season, so he knows about winning as well. Brough is underneath that restart, across the field so far, looking to straighten up.
That's a sign of a confident player. Halfback would normally feed a forward who's running on dead strong. Danny Brough decides to just take it upon himself to get the momentum going.
Westerman, National League Young Player of the Year during the week. And really plays well above his age. He's 17 years old. He looks so confident out there.
There aren't many teenagers who can play like a man, but Joe Westerman's shown that he can do that this season. Made a good start in this game.
Here from the other end of the spectrum, age-wise, Owen Guttenbeel. 31 years old, behind only second to Stacey Jones in terms of appearances for the Warriors. Brough hoists that kick, and that's one for Grix to deal with. He's got the Tiger up. Army bearing down on him, but he stood firm underneath that one. They're running it out of defence, and Damien Blanche looking to get away. It needed a good tackle from Shenton to stop him. That was bold, adventurous. Has he stolen that one, Shenton?
No, it's still Widnes' ball. Widnes showed a lot of courage on their own line, willing to throw that ball around.
The Tigers very quickly off the line there. Wilkes steaming it in. They're still inside their own 40, though.
Widnes haven't had the ball in Castleford's half, and I think that's the reason now why Castleford working so hard to get up and contain this goal forward from the Vikings. The longer they can deny that, the greater their chance of success tonight.
Bezic puts a drilled kick in all the way along the ground, goes out of play near the 20 in the Castleford half.
It's not a bad little kick, that. Players are often trying to keep the ball on the island to keep the momentum and keep the game flowing, so you can have a go at that energy battle. But Bob Bezic, put the ball in touch there, just slow the game. Let's just catch our breath, lads. 8.5 minutes gone.
You can see there from Widnes' game plan right from the first 8 minutes that they're targeting Andrew Henderson around the middle of the pitch. And they know that when he gets tired, Danny Brough has to go into acting halfback, and it probably takes a lot away from Danny Brough's game.
It's Kirk Dixon taking the ball up. He's on the wing now with that positional switch from Terry Maddison, McGoldrick in the centre and Dixon starting on the wing, which is where he's more at home, in fact, Kirk Dixon. It's Michael Wainwright who was demoted to the bench, so it'd be disappointing for Wainwright. Guttenbeel, good strong run from the Kiwi, and a great offload as well to Donlan, and Donlan through the middle! Stuart Donlan trying to go all the way, but needed a good tackle from his opposite number. number grit. But here comes Shenton. Brough now. Brough across the field, puts the kick in. And Griggs it is who hammers it dead. They had men out wide, maybe chose the wrong option there, but they'll get the ball back from this dropout under the posts.
I think this is great recovery from Widnes. When the line is broken, you can see the desperation. Fantastic offload to Donlan. Signs through the gap, accelerates, but Griggs, his opposite number, takes him down. And again, just look at the white shirts. Desperate, Griggs again, clears the ball over the dead ball line.
So, Castleford Tigers having all the possession really in this opening
shot.
10 minutes, and all the territory as well. It's all in the Widnes' half, really. Here is Westerman again as they drive forwards once more. Just two tackles gone. Higgins, offload to Thackeray. Thackeray Clayton comes back infield, and nice footwork from Clayton until he runs into the tackle from Wilkson Noon. Ooh, from the Tiger supporters. They thought that one was high. Westerman now trying his luck. Tackled by Cassidy, twice his age, Cassidy. Thackeray, Brough now. Brough, it was headbutted, I think, from Toa Coe Love.
It's off his shoulder.
That's the fifth tackle. And the crossfield kick from Brough. And it's alive, it's still alive. And somebody has touched that one down. Well, I think Dixon got the ball down, but how did it come free? Dixon claiming it, but there's a debate now about how that ball came to be virtually at his feet.
Well, everybody in the ground knows just how difficult Danny Brough's kicks will be. Widnes can't get to put pressure on him quickly enough. And although Gavin Dodd appears unchallenged to take the ball, he maybe leaves the ground too early. Here's the kick again. The player's clearly onside. Dixon, who's Castleford's top try scorer this season, waits patiently, just times his run to perfection. And as Dodd goes up, it bounces off his shoulder, goes back into the Ingle area. Does Dixon score this try here? Does he get downward pressure?
Yes,
he does. That's the first try of this game. 10 minutes into it, and Castleford will go 8-0 ahead. Do you know what? Playing on the wing, Barry, I've said this before, it's a difficult job.
It is, and I've come to appreciate now that the wingers, you know, sometimes you could be accused of taking easy options, but when you've got decisions like that to make, and Gavin Dodd, you know, there was a lot of action in and around him. He had to look at the ball, not take his eyes off the ball for a second. He could actually have been tackled in mid-air.
That's what I was wondering, was he tackled in the air?
I thought there was a case at first look, but the video ref just looking at the grounding, I think.
Doesn't appear to be much doubt about that one. But does he bounce it? It's a minute bounce if it is there.
Does it leave his forearm?
It bounces,
can't see
all
from
right.
That angle, though, can you properly?
Ooh.
This is the one where you can see it best. He touches it there, just goes down.
It's a knock on though.
Just leaves in.
The more you show it and the slower you look at it, the more you feel that it is a knock on. Does the arm momentarily leave? There is probably space, yes.
Yeah.
Wow,
that's minute.
It is.
it still leaves his forearm though, doesn't it, Bill?
That shows you how close the line between success and failure will be here tonight. Very little to separate these two sides. The video referee has to make a big call.
Well, what is the call from video referee Ian Smith? Dixon watches. Has he got try number 24 this season? Denied! The Tigers supporters and Terry Maddison bemused by that.
Do you know what the interesting thing is, though? The semi-final, the first half, when Casper plays to show the replay again, he judges that he knocks on just around here. But the first time we played in the semi-final, that Castleford, all they've done was kick to the left-hand side, their left-hand side. They had no joy, and then they started targeting McNan inside on the right-hand side, and that's where they've looked like they started off the game today.
Aaron Summers is on, replacing Mick Cassidy. Summers himself recovered from a calf injury, rumoured to be heading for Celtic Crusaders for next season for their National League One campaign. That was a wild pass, and Moran an even wilder kick, and they could pay for this. Oh, and Toa Coe Love did ever so well there to get that ball back and retrieve the situation for Widnes Vikings, because for one moment it looked as though Danny Williams was going to get away with that. And that was really careless from the Widnes Vikings, and they could have been punished.
You could accuse them of an element of panic at present. The game hasn't started the way they wanted it to. Casimir have control, and the kick goes high, comes back again now this time. Bezic, still the last tackle, kicks it through again.
And Dixon is there to retrieve the ball just for a while. It looked as though Simon Griggs might get there. Scott Griggs, beg your pardon.
I think you're right, Phil, when you say that Widnes are panicking a little bit. Big games are won and lost on split-second decisions, and getting the little things right. Quite Love comes up with a big shot again, and getting the little things right consistently puts you in that great position.
Danny Williams felt that. He's down on his knees, clutching his shoulder. It was a big hit on the winger. There he is. So that's a problem. Westerman, though, in possession for the Tigers. They lead by 4-0, twice denied, though, by the video ref. Dominating the first 12 minutes here. And Widnes having to weather the storm.
That's
David
a good
Blanche
kick.
Having to run that back eventually. He was hoping desperately he would run dead. Shenton with the tackle. Nothing wrong with that, says referee Bentham.
It looked a little high.
It certainly did.
Widnes would be desperate for a penalty as Tompkins takes it forward. The forwards need to work very hard here, because Casford won't let up. They're not making it easy to get out of their own half. And they want to keep a very firm, tight grip on top of Widnes.
Jordan James, as they get towards halfway, but that's the fifth tackle. Mark Smith then puts the kick in. It's well placed between Donlan, and it's Donlan who gets there first before his winger Kirk Dixon. Then a good chase from Widnes.
That's probably the best minute the Widnes have played in this game. It's taken them 13 to get there, but they've worked it up to the halfway line, they've kicked it well, and they're in the wrestle now.
And Danny Williams is leaving the field. He's in trouble as a result of that big hit on him. Certainly did the job. Nothing illegal about it, and I think he was putting his shoulder into it, and he's come off with the shoulder injury. Here is Guttenbeel. Summers puts the wraps on him and drives him to the ground. Tompkins there as well. There is Danny Williams. Got off to a flying start when he came to Castleford with a hat-trick on his debut. Tompkins again with the tackle on Henderson this time. Shenton, Brough, hoists that kick high into the evening air. Underneath it is Dodd, and Dodd didn't want to know about it. Dixon did, and Dixon, well, they're playing pat-a-cake with that ball, and knock on. Judged by Kirk Dixon in the end, I think.
Nice positioning here from the referee. He's up alongside it. You can see whose arm touches the ball. It is Dixon's left arm. Goes forward, and there's a relief again, but you can bet that Gavin Dodd will be receiving one or two more of those during
good
the next
shot,
hour.
Yeah. Big shot by Alan Guttenbeel targeting McMahon in there. But, you know, it's what you do over the 80 minutes that win you the games. And I know the big players and who come up with the big players have an effect on the game, but you've got to do the right things for the full 80 minutes to get the result.
Darting break from Mark Smith. Almost found a hole in the Castleford Tigers' defence. Just managing to bring him down. Castleford, as expected, dominating possession. But Widnes just beginning to inch their way back into the game now. Just seeing a bit more of the ball. It's what they can do with it that's the question. Meanwhile, Michael Wainwright, left out of the Castleford starting lineup in a bit of a shock, finds himself already involved in the action. Danny Williams is off. So that change didn't last very long for Terry Matteson.
Another step end up, come on.
Now then, here's Joel Penny. Penny.
10 metres, Dennis. Let him run to.
Reaches Donlan, or Donlan reaches that ball, and then Penny reaches him to make the tackle. And now Wainwright, first touch of the ball for the winger.
That's probably the farthest Widnes have been into Castleford's half all game. And as slowly as you say, they're working their way down there. But the speed of the play of the ball, vastly different when Castleford have it to Widnes. The man finds his front, falls up, gets up quickly, and it's allowing them to play with width.
Problems for Widnes Vikings as well, because Aaron Summers, and problems for Castleford here. Aaron Summers has limped off injured. Meanwhile, Castleford Tigers have conceded possession carelessly, and Widnes have come up with it, and this is certainly their best field position of the game so far. Can they make anything of this now? Penny. Jordan James. James is lifted and almost lifted too high by Henderson. Now on the field, Lee Duran, and his first touch is to drive the ball forward for Widnes. Widnes threatening the Castleford try line. Here is Dennis Moran. Moran, Toakoi Love. Three in there for the Tigers to make the tackle in front of this packed south stand full of Castleford supporters. Griggs puts the kick in, it's too strong.
Too deep.
You're quite right. Field position has been at a minimum for Widnes, and when they've got down there, devoid of ideas, the chase was nowhere near good enough, nor the kick.
Wainwright bitterly involved since he came on, so too Liapa. Liapa good offload to Henderson. Henderson finds Brough now. Brough, well, springing his step, that's for sure.
Goose step.
Dixon is tackled on the halfway line. Thackeray, Lupton now. His captain Henderson there, looking left then right, and then finds Thackeray. Thackeray back in field to Guttenbeel. Guttenbeel slings that ball out the back. Now with Westerman. Westerman and Nannin go toe-to-toe. And it's Nannin who brings him down. Brough now, Brough. Will he try the kick? He won't. He'll pop it up for McGoldrick. McGoldrick still going, gets the ball away. And it's into the hands of a Widnes player. The second time they've done that.
That's a brilliant set for Castleford. They may not have scored at the end of it, but they look so dangerous. Keeping the ball alive, breaking through tackles, and most importantly, supporting the man with the ball. Widnes under pressure here. They need somebody to get them out of trouble, or they need a penalty. They'll do anything here to get out to their own half, because it's been a case of survival there for a few minutes.
Scott Griggs plays the ball. Penny was a bit cramped for room then. He had his teammate Jordan James just about standing on his toes as he looked for room to make the kick. Moran with the tackle on Wainwright. Here's Liapa. Castleford just short of the halfway line. Westerman now.
There's just nothing in this game at all. As the Castleford look like they want to get to the middle of the field, split both halfbacks, and just have a look at playing and attacking. With Brough and with Thackeray, they think they've got the players to break down this Widnes defence.
Chris Charles plays the ball. This will be his last game for the Castleford Tigers. He's off to France as player coach of Villeneuve. And he wants to bow out with a bit of glory, helping the side get into Super League. Brough tries the kick. Moran read that one well.
He's got it all.
This could be a try, although the pass is a wild one to Wainwright. Wainwright will score. Wainwright gets the try. Moran had diffused the danger, but then he lost possession. And Castleford Tigers, in a game like this, you can't squander opportunities like that. And Michael Wainwright, demoted to the bench at the start of this game, on in place of Danny Williams, was there to score the try. Consolation for Dennis Moran. Points for the Castleford Tigers.
Well, errors like this come for two reasons. One, because you've been working too hard in defence, and secondly, because your opponents are just putting you under pressure. It's a good little kick through, just short, behind the line. Moran gets to it, but he knows his opposite numbers on him straight away. As he hits the ground, the ball comes out, and the quick thinking there from Castleford have gifted the substitute Wainwright the chance to go over for the first try. It's been almost error-free in the opening quarter from Castleford, and you can contrast that with Widnes. Not able to start this game as they would like, under pressure, and now standing behind the post, waiting to see whether this kick will be converted.
Danny Brough looking to drift this kick in, but he's pushed it across the face of the post. But the first try of the game, third time of asking for the Castleford Tigers. They lead by 8 points to nil. And Wainwright, the try scorer, that's his 18th of the season and his fourth in the last five games, so he's given the right answer, hasn't he?
He certainly has, and for him and his teammates now, it's about maintaining a control on the game that they've had from the start of this match. That's an almost perfect opening quarter, but they have to continue the concentration here. Very often we see after points are scored, there can be a break, a lapse in the flow of the game, but certainly not there from Liapa.
They have got to concentrate, Phil, you're right. There's 60 minutes left to go, and with people like Mark Smith and Joel Penny and Dennis Moran, Widnes will be looking. They just want to force the error up this end of the pitch and really take it to the next level, because they haven't been up here, they've not been in attacking field position. and that's where they've been struggling down in their own 20.
I think Castleford's go forward's been absolutely bob on. They just get out of their own half with little or no effort whatsoever. They've got good ball movement. Now and then there's an offload, but it's just about speed. Quick play the ball.
No speed there, but Widnes up quickly to close down the danger from Thackeray. Now Brough puts the kick in, and it's behind Dodd, hurrying back to retrieve that ball, but it's a good chase. McGoldrick leading the way. And McGoldrick and Brough driving him back, and that was outrageous from Gavin Dodd.
But they're forced to have to come up with some magic passes because of the intensity of that chase. There's no point having one of the best kickers in rugby league in this country, Danny Brough, in your side, if you're not going to go 100% sprint effort when he puts the ball downfield. And that's what the Casper teammates have done. They complimented the kick, and the intensity here now is looking to force a mistake.
There's an intensity from the Castleford Tigers supporters as well. I think the entire population of the jungle is here.
But again, from that kick again, Widnes will have to know, and Gavin Dodd and Mick Nairn will have to be aware.
Things like that can change a game. Marker's not square. It's a bit of relief for Widnes, and maybe an opportunity. They certainly needed a break.
That's an indication of the domination of Castleford Tigers, because that's the Widnes Vikings' first penalty.
And that's the importance of that back three. Griggs, Dodd and Damian Blanche start that role and get that quick play of the ball. And so far, 23 minutes, that's the first time they've done it.
But what I was going to say, that they've got to be aware on the left-hand side of Widnes, that that's the side that the kicking game of Brough is going to target. Gavin Dodd has got to drop back, and Mick Nannings has got to hug that touchline.
So Widnes, can they get points on the board?
They need to support him when he carries the ball. We've seen him in National League this year. Look, quick play the ball.
He didn't play that properly, did he?
He's not going to penalise
him. That was a real shambles.
Do you think that's right, Bill?
I don't think he tried to get to his feet, never mind being denied the opportunity.
He's hoping to play the ball. Yeah. It's a perfect play the ball. It's a mistake
so as well.
By the referee.
It's Westerman trying to slow the momentum down, and that's what I said. They want to get that speed back into their game, because when Widnes are going quick and they're going fast and they've got bodies in motion, they're really dangerous.
You could say that Widnes deserved a penalty there. Westerman clinging on as Duran tried to get to his feet to play the ball.
And he plays it, doesn't he? Too quickly for a free. Okay,
his right hand's got hold of him, Phil.
Doesn't make contact with the boot, but other than that, there's more illegality in the tackle from Castleford than Widnes missed play.
So it's not going the Vikings' way so far. They're 8-0 down on the scoreboard. And the little things going against them, but Donlan, tackled by Nannin, scrags him and puts him to the ground. McGoldrick, here's Chris Charles. About 15 metres out, Charles. That's the fifth tackle. Brough. Even at this early stage, he's going for 1 point and getting it.
I'd be happy if I was a Widnes player and that had just happened. That wouldn't worry me too much. I just want to get away from my own trial. And Danny Brough's relaxed. He thinks it keeps the scoreboard ticking over. I don't think that's a big problem. There's no difference really between 8 and 9-0 in rugby league.
There's a point difference.
There is a point difference. There's little difference, I should
little
say.
Difference, yeah.
Correct myself.
I were no good at maths, but I knew nine were more than eight.
Only just, because you had your abacus out.
The artful dodger, Danny Brough, just filching another point for his side. 9-0 they lead. And
that's the point.
Lost that ball.
That's the point I'm making, Barry. OK, you've got your extra point with a 9, but now all of a sudden, the black and white jerseys have got the ball 20 metres from Casper's line. It's the first time they've started a set this close to Casper's try line.
And how many times do you see the error when a team kicks off?
I think Lee Duran actually knocked the ball out.
I think he did.
But he's gone one over.
Aaron Summers is back on the pitch.
Penny then is tackled. Widnes with a great opportunity here. Damian Blanche, but he slips. Can't blame the pitch. It's in great nick, despite the fact it had two games on it already and another one on Friday night. Summers is back on, obviously restored to full fitness. I think he got winded, in fact, Aaron Summers. He was on the sidelines, gulping air. Penny now. Here is Dennis Moran, looking to atone for that error. Gavin Dodd had to reach for that one as it was sailing towards the touchline. And that ball was forward, says the touch judge. So Widnes, even when they get into the danger zone, can't do anything to help themselves. Frustrating for the coach.
Well, you'd probably have to say that the outside wide men just overran this play, didn't they? And by the time Gricks had got themselves into a position on a second-man play to use either Nannin or Dodd, they were either in front of him or decided to come back on the inside. It's just a lack of patience from centre Mick Nannin.
Maybe Gricks was wanting Nannin to come on that nice little unders line that they used at the Halifax match, but Mick Nannin chose to stare it wide and then he was neither in nor out.
Donlan is tackled about 40 metres out for the Castleford Tigers, who lead by 9-0. Liafa, this time he makes sure he keeps a hold of the ball as the South Sea Islander. Brough going for a 40-20, he's given that some welly. It could get there.
And what a kick. That was
great
inch
kick.
Perfect,
what a kick.
That. Inch perfect. Nice left-footed kick. He was aware of the 40-metre line. Drifted over to his better side off a left foot. Perfect.
This must be heartbreaking for a coach to know that a player like this is leaving the side and he puts on a performance like this.
I don't think the coaches are thinking past the next hour and a half, Bill. Now his teammates need to put some quality on the end of this kick. Here's a chance. Thackeray.
Shenton. A step in field. Men out to the right. McGoldrick is one of them. McGoldrick is over for the try. Ryan McGoldrick capitalises on that kick from Danny Brough in the most perfect way for the Castleford Tigers. And Ryan McGoldrick justifies the coach's faith with his 12th try of the season. A surprise selection in the centres, restored to the starting lineup. And that was why.
Well, they're making rugby league look a pretty simple game. You play the ball quicker than your opponents, it can be easy, but you have to work to get into those positions. They were taken downfield by, well, one of the best kicks you'll see in this country this year. That's almost perfect. And then look, they're up quickly. With this turn even back on side, bit of fancy footwork, puts you in the hole, then lean forward, press hard, and hope to land on your front, on the ball in the end goal area. That's what he does. And that's the second try for Castleford.
It's Danny Brough's 40-20 that created the platform for that try. And now can he round it off with this conversion attempt? Well, his kicking out of hand has been great, but he's missed with his last two kicks with the boot. But 13-0, Castleford Tigers lead. Brough not looking happy with himself. Ryan McGoldrick will be, though. The biker from Cairns really roaring over for that try.
Again, the isolated, it was 3-on-3, but Mick Nannin run behind Paul Noon. That's something you can't do. You can't break the defensive line. And when you're defending your line, you've got to move like sideways, not behind the player. You've got to keep your line. And they're really isolating that left-hand side of Widnes.
Real character, Ryan McGoldrick, likes his Harley Davidson. Here is Mark Liapa. So Widnes already 13-0 down after half an hour. They need to find some foothold in this game because they've spent the first half hour largely on the back foot.
They need to find something, don't they, because at the minute they're just defending too much in their own 40 and they're never going to win a game, even with the skillful players that they've got.
Liapa avoids the high shot. Clayton. Shenton now. Shenton going for the line. Back in field. Great defence from Griggs. Just flung an arm out as the pass came over and Castleford were in then.
Well, if they scored to win this game, this is a £1 million tackle here from Scott Griggs. There's tremendous speed here. Look at him, he looks running so strongly and quickly for the corner, but Griggs came across. He looks to get the ball back on the inside to his teammate Wainwright. The ball goes out of play. The referee says that Widnes didn't play at it and therefore they'll get possession from this scrum.
So that is a major let-off for the Widnes Vikings. 13-0, still looks within distance. Another 4-6 points and you start to see the Super League place receding into the distance.
But they need to get out of their own half, Bill. They've been awful coming away from their own line. They've struggled to make 20 metres as Castleford halt. I think it's Aaron Summers there with the ball in his hand and he's only made two.
It's been a great half hour from the Castleford Tigers. Just about inch perfect. Very few mistakes. Very few penalties conceded. Nannin rumbling over the 40-metre line. Now here is Penny. Puts that kick deep, and Wainwright will watch that one go over the dead ball line. Tap on the 20 for the Castleford Tigers. And Phil Bentham wants them back on the line in the middle.
And again, I know it's gone dead, Bill, but look at the witness line now. Defensively, they're set. If they go through them, it's going to be through some weak defence or some real strong running.
Some teams actually mean to do that. They actually mean to get the ball dead. The defensive line is set. When you kick it down and you keep it in play, you're relying on two or three players chasing out.
Oh, Moran, a characteristic intercept there as Lee Apper offloaded the ball. Wilkes. Just carelessness from Lee Apper.
Hold here.
Should know with a poacher like Dennis Moran around not to do that.
Do you think Dennis called for that?
I was going to say it's probably a clever play by Dennis, knowing Mark Lee Apper offloading every time he can do.
Witness haven't had a successful ending to a set at this part of the field. They've either lost the ball or given it away too easily. They need to somehow either force a goal line drop out or even score in this set. But they need to stay at this end of the field, Bill, if they want to stay alive.
Change of direction, another change of direction, then Noon gets it back to Penny, and Penny thought he'd seen a gap. Eventually the Tigers' defence comes scrambling back to get a hold of him, but that's the fifth tackle. Just in the shadow of those posts. Now Moran. Moran, kick to the wing. Oh, over the heads of Damien Blanche.
Again, a poor end to the set. Going for broke, going for the try. May well have been better, sir, just to put it behind the defensive line and make Castleford run out from their own line.
He's going through the agonies is the Widnes Vikings coach, Steve McCormack. Speaking of grand finals, there's a small matter of next Saturday, Super League 12, grand final.
And that's Mark Leaffer's third mistake. I think Terry Matheson will be furious here. The ball's lost.
Again, a witness hand on the ball, though. Those penalties can go either side.
Terry Matheson, a grand final winner with the Brisbane Broncos in his playing days, now looking to win a grand final with the Castleford Tigers. He's got a foothold there, but Widnes Vikings looking to get back on the, or get on the scoreboard before the half-time hooter sounds, and this is their best opportunity, and Damien Blanche tries his own, but is stopped just short. Bezic, Penny. Don't make any progress there. Penny eventually gets to his feet. Mark Smith now. Smith, two dummies. They get a hold of him, and Castleford Tigers were offside.
Well, they've got to stay at this end of the field. They will tap it and go again.
Wilkes will try the direct route, but he's met with force by Chris Charles. Bezic fires the ball out. Nannin trying to bulldoze his way over. He is over, but now he's driven back.
I think he's claiming he's got the ball down.
He says he's got the ball down, and Phil Bentham agrees. Well, Nannin just stretched a hand out in the middle of that maze of bodies, and he's given the try. And Phil Bentham was perfectly positioned to see that. Right under his nose, and under the noses of those Castleford Tigers defences.
I think this is about the only the third play the ball that Castleford have tried to defend on their own line, and Widnes will be happy there because they've shown three attempts, one try. That's not a bad conversion ratio. Look at that wonderful control of the ball in the right hand, got hold of the ball, and all the defenders are trying to keep him up in the air. Nobody is close to the ball. He grounds it on the line. Great try from Mick Nannin. Top try scorer for Widnes this year. You can tell why. When he gets close to it, he knows that you've got to come away with a try.
This is the kick that faces Mick Nannin now. He is a phenomenal points machine, a machine for this Widnes side. Not only this season, just about every season. There you go, 160 goals. 428 points, well, 432 points now. Another 2 points for his side would be a massive boost before half-time. He's missed with that one. Nevertheless, that Mick Nanning try makes it 13-4. And Widnes have at least got points on the board and given the cast of the Tigers something to think about.
Look at the strength of the lad. He's got four men on him, and the lad's 18 stone. And you know, anywhere near the line, if Mick Nanning gets the ball, you've got to be on your guard, because he can do that all day, and he breaks the record at every club he goes to.
As a defender, you're sometimes you're guilty of trying to stop them from getting over the line, when really all you've got to do is make sure you're holding the pill and the player can't put the ball down.
Well, he's not the most elegant of players, Mick Nanning, but he's pretty effective, you've got to say that.
Just giving his team a lifeline, hasn't he? Under pressure, looking somewhat fatigued, I thought, dropping off one or two tackles, losing the ruck. But now, just the energy that a try gives to a team, everyone runs it 5% harder, gets up to play the ball half a second quicker, and it just lifts the rest of the side.
That's probably the best go-forward set that Widnes have done all game.
Clayton in firmly with the tackle on Mark Smith, but Castleford Tigers leading by 13 points to 4. They'll feel hard done by, two disallowed by the video ref. Quite rightly disallowed. But they've dominated the first half hour here and not really converted that possession and position into enough points.
Bill, I've said before, you can attack in rugby league when you don't have the ball. You can put your opponents under pressure. This is an opportunity for Widnes to do that now. Castleford have had it too easy, just carting the ball forward. Good strong carry again by Westerman, but Widnes needs to get up with some good speed in the line. Force the Castleford players backwards, not forwards.
Here's another one of these great Castleford youngsters, Ryan Boyle, 19 years old, thundering that ball forward. The Tigers fans urging Phil Bentham to give him a penalty for offside. Keswick is quickly out of the line on Brough, and that is good pressure, but nobody else was alert. And Castleford have it back. Now it's with Wainwright. Wainwright, little chip ahead. And Grix very coolly watches that one go dead.
I've been fascinated to see whether the tackle count had actually been restarted there. No, Wainwright didn't really have a chance to stop and ask the referee. I'm not sure whether he had five or six more tackles up the sleeve before he chipped over and went for the corner. As we go, 80 seconds to half-time. Will there be a further score?
Well, in fact, Phil Bentham had wiped the tackle count clean, so they could have made a bit more of that instead of having a rush of blood. Here's Penny. Wilkes now. Wilkes booms the ball out for Nanning, and Nanning had Dodd outside him, but he's taken it himself. And here comes Noon. Noon for Grix. Grix. Oh, and Penny has spilled that one. Joel Penny had the try line at his mercy there.
You say that, Bill. I think he still had Donlan and one or two others. Got a bit of hard cover around him. Shenton was behind him. Thacker was coming across in cover. Not sure he would have made it from there.
Ooh. And McCormack knows that in a game like this, you've got to take opportunities. Joel Penny knows that one. He's been in this situation before. He's lost a grand final before. And Terry Madison, well, we saw him thumping the furniture in delight when Wainwright scored. But a look of concern on the face of the Tigers coach, because they've just allowed Widnes to get a grip on this game, a foothold in this game, which they didn't really deserve. And the first half will end with Widnes feeling a lot more optimistic about their prospects than they should do, because Castleford Tigers, Terry Madison's side, have dominated that first 40 largely, and Steve McCormack's men have been rewarded for just hanging in there. It looked as though Castleford Tigers were going to take this game by the scruff of the neck. They were 13-0 up. They were putting pressure on Widnes all the time, but Widnes managed to fight their way back. Nanning managed to fight his way over the try line, and at half time it's 13 points to 4 in favour of the Castleford Tigers.
Yes, 13-4 to the Castleford Tigers, but number 4 for Widnes, Mick Nanning, he just poached a try, didn't he? After Widnes had a torrid first 30 minutes here at Headingley. Castleford Tigers are halfway there, but there's a big 40 minutes still to come. End or thereabouts of a long day, and Castleford Tigers have been waiting, and so have Widnes been waiting to get on centre stage. And the Tigers are ahead at half-time, 13 points to 4. Castleford Tigers then just 40 minutes away from the place in the Super League next year, but they're being given the right fight by the Widnes Vikings, as you would expect. For 30 minutes, it was all Castleford. The last 10 minutes, Widnes really came back into it, and the tri-poacher supreme, Mick Nannin, just pinched the 4 points. And Widnes will turn round with a little bit of heart right now, and they'll be hearing the words of Steve McCormack in that dressing room with fresh ears, I'm sure. Barry and Terry are here with me in the studio. Is that a fair summation of the first 40? Castleford looked like they were home and hose.
They were virtually perfect, and they just kept knocking them sets out, just playing good yardage, and they were very, very good coming away from their own line. And Widnes were awful coming away from their own line. But here we see the no-try from Thackeray, who, just as Tez identified at the start of the game, showed that drop-off and went close. And another one that was disallowed for Castleford.
That was by Dixon. I thought that was reminiscent of one that was given on Friday in the Leeds-Wigan game. But then Wainwright...
But then the pressure here off Brough just pressures Dennis Moran, the body on top of Dennis, forces the ball out. Clayton following up, puts a long ball out there to Wainwright, just steps off his left foot and scores the try.
So that was the breakthrough that Castleford were looking for. Then, well, Danny Brough has had a fantastic hand, or should it be foot, in this game, hasn't he?
He's been very influential with his boot, and this 40-20 is as good as you'll see anywhere this year. Knows exactly where to put it, and from that field position, it's McGoldrick, lovely little step here, and has the strength to get over. And it's Wainwright who's unlucky, he misses out, but when you've got players like that, you've got to use them.
But Mick Nannin here, ball of Bob Bezeker, a good ball, attracts four defenders to him. And as I say, this lad's 18 stone, and anywhere near the line, he's got the power to get over. And he knew straight from minute one when he put that down that that was a try.
I must say, we have to give credit to Phil Bentham, the referee there. He was in exactly the right place to make the decision on that. And then Joel Penny late on, he had a chance when the line was beckoning.
Could that be crucial? When you get opportunities like that in big games, you need to capitalise points-wise.
But what they were doing, they were running into the right hole to Widnes, which the first 30 minutes, they weren't running into the right holes. The right pass option wasn't there. But the last 10 minutes of the game, that try really gave Widnes that lift that they were looking for. They were looking for somebody in the team to inspire them, and Mick Nannin come up with that play.
Indeed so, and it will certainly change the emphasis, I'm sure, of Steve McCormack's half-time team talk that's taking place right now. Castleford, they're on the end of this fantastic unbeaten record, 10 consecutive matches since they last lost to Widnes in June. Can Widnes come back? Got the grand final here in National League, of course, taking place, but the big one is the Engage Super League grand final on Saturday night. St Helens will take on Leeds Rhinos. It's a 5:30 start, Sky Sports 1, and in high definition on HD1, channel 408. Over 70-odd thousand of us will be there, and we all hope and pray that this fellow will be as well, because Steve Prescott has limped his way into Headingley. Is at his halfway point of his walk from Hull to Old Trafford for the big night, raising funds, of course, for his very special charity appeal. And Steve Prescott's halfway there, and he's limping a bit, isn't he, the boy? But he's going to get there, he said, by hook or by crook. Well, there is a very important 40 minutes still to come here at Headingley tonight in the National League One Grand Final. Will Castleford maintain this half-time lead, or will Widnes come back and take the place in Super League next year? Mick Nannin's try certainly giving them hope. Let's go back to the commentary box. Bill, Phil, Barry and Terry. Bill.
And Steve Prescott will be on his way from Bradford to Marsden near Huddersfield tomorrow, calling in at the George Hotel on the way. So if you are on that route, get out and show him your support. A lot of people have been. Meanwhile, a generous start to the second half from the Castleford Tigers, spilling that kick-off into the hands of the Widnes Vikings. And Oliver Wilkes drives that ball up. Well, you can't ask for more than that at the beginning of the second half. Mark Smith now. Dennis Moran. Moran pops the ball up for Tompkins, and Tompkins is almost through. Good defence from Shenton and Clayton, the unsung hero of this Tigers side, Ryan Clayton. But here comes Bezic. Needed a good tackle from Westerman right underneath those posts now. Four tackles gone. Joel Penny. Penny gets the ball away to Noon. Noon back to Penny. Nannin looking for a second try. Nannin looking to use his strength again, and he could get there. He has got there, has he? He's held up this time.
Again, great positioning from the official. He's held up in the in-goal area, so play will continue. They're 10 metres out now on the last tackle. But you can see the Castleford awareness now. When the kick goes through, it's in the in-goal area. Knocked down by Henderson.
They'll get another set of six.
If the rugby league gods had been able to grant a wish to witness at half-time, it would have been that they got the ball back from the kick-off and then they're given a repeat set. This is a perfect start for Widnes to offer them a chance of getting back into this game after a very disappointing opening 40.
Joel Penny underneath that restart. Here is Cassidy now. So the Tigers on the back foot immediately at the start of this second half. And here is Wilkes. Wilkes takes the tackle. No fancy stuff from Oliver Wilkes. Now Penny. Penny. Back for Bezic. Bezic tackled on the 20-metre line. Plays that ball. Cassidy now. Cassidy has Noon on his shoulder. Wilkes on his shoulder, in fact. Dennis Moran. Getting away from one man and then getting the pass away. Griggs. Griggs puts the kick in. Nobody on the same wavelength. So he goes himself, Griggs. And it's going to be a tap on the 20 after all that. But for a moment, Griggs' opportunism almost paid off.
This would have probably been the best individual try I've ever seen to get around the man, get the ball at the in-goal area. He's terribly unlucky. But maybe casting, they've just survived what could have been a killer comeback blow.
They started off having a witness with a different tempo and a different attitude to the way they started off the game. They're not showing any respect the way that they're coming up with shots like that from Toa Coilov, but playing down there. Witness do have the big name players and the big players who've played in the big stage to come up with them tries, and what a great effort there by Griggs. You were dead right, Phil.
What a good effort from Ryan Boyle to drive that ball forwards up towards the 40-metre line.
Very impressed with Ryan Boyle. Every time I see him play, he's big, strong and brave.
No wonder they wanted to keep a hold of him, signed a two-year contract extension, very keen to get his name on the contract. On the last tackle now, and look for the kick from Brough. It's a little chip and chase himself. Griggs has obviously inspired him. Oh, what an inspirational try! What a try from Alan Guttenbeil! What a superb kick from Danny Brough. And Alan Guttenbeil, who pledged his loyalty to this Castleford Tigers side when they were relegated. He could have turned his back on them when they slipped out of Super League. He decided to stay with them. He wanted to see them back into Super League. And he is repaying that faith. But it was the kick that set it all up.
Well, you've just seen the beauty of rugby league in 2 minutes there. Widnes almost scored at one end through Griggs, and Castleford, with their ability to go to the other end, kick the ball through again. It's one in which the ball bounced up for them, and the grip here on the ball was the thing that allowed Guttenbeil to get over the line. Once he's spinning wide, is it the high kick, is it the long kick, or is it the chip kick? And it's that mixture of kicking game from Danny Brough today that's made him difficult to play against, and now he puts the kick between the two uprights.
They will miss Danny Brough. He's going to be at Wakefield next season, and John Keir will be rubbing his hands with glee at the prospect of Danny Brough pulling the strings for his side. The Castleford Tigers are relishing the prospect of a return to Super League. Alan Guttenbeil with the try that has put them on the way at the start of the second half.
And that one player there is why I talk about the grip, and the grip being so essential in rugby league. Get your thumb round the ball, and Alan Guttenbeil was tackled 5 metres away from the line, but because he had a thumb around the ball instead of tucked in the teddy bear position, he was able to reach that extra yard or half a metre.
Widnes had the best possible start to the second half. Castleford gifting them possession. Two sets of tackles on the Cass line, but they weren't able to break the defence. And Castleford, really, with their first attack of the second half, have come up with the points and lead 19-4 now.
And that disheartens you, that one. You threw everything at Castleford, and they were defending the line. You come up with all the players that you practice in training, and you don't score a try. And Danny Brough just weaves that bit of magic, puts a kick in, comes up with a try at the other end. It does take a lot out of you.
Brough with the kick. He got the Players' Player of the Year award at the Rugby League National League Awards night, the RLPA GMB Players' Player of the Year, to give its full title. But I imagine that he must be a very annoying player to play against, because he just puts the rapier in, doesn't he? Puts the little daggers in.
Especially when you're a big lad in the middle of the field and all he does is keep kicking it over your head and you have to keep retreating to your own 20. Yeah, he does annoy the big lads.
All that matters now, Bill, is what's with this reaction. How will they respond? When you're behind in a race, you can either intensify your effort, push harder, work even harder when you don't have the ball, or maybe you can feel sorry for yourself. Widnes cannot afford that. Still a long time to go in the game.
Now Dennis Moran's at it, fancies a kick and chase, and that ball eventually goes into touch. Well, Moran overran it. He was going so fast.
He was expecting that bounce, that third bounce, and it's already bounced up over his head. And he was expecting maybe a little trickle. And I'm not sure whether Stuart Donlan were just looking at Dennis expecting it to come into his hands.
Shake of the head from Dennis Moran. Doesn't want to be on the losing end again, but it's looking like it. And there is the South Stand, absolutely jam-packed. And this time it's jam-packed with Castleford Tigers supporters, jam-packed on Friday night with Leeds Rhinos fans, delighted to see their side progress to the grand final. Those Tigers fans in there tonight hope to see their side win this grand final, and they're well on course for it now, 19-4 ahead. But they started the first half like this, dominant, got points on the board, and then allowed their opponents to come back into the game. Henderson, the Devonian Australian, plays the ball, and now Brough. This time goes for a more orthodox kick. And Damien Blanch is underneath it, but look at that chase from the Tigers. And Brough leading the way. Noon now. Tackled on the 20-metre line. Cassidy makes another few metres, but it's hard work to get these yards for the Widnes Vikings. Now Jordan James, another player being linked with the Celtic side for their National League One campaign. This is what Widnes maybe need, a few more of those from Mark Smith.
That is what Widnes need, and they need Bob Bezzett, the lad who's gone in behind that, then have to follow Mark Smith and do the same, because when they do that, they're devastating.
They need more players to chase the ball when they kick it, Bill, with a greater effort and intensity. If you look at the Melbourne Storm side, the best team in Australia, their major focus is on chasing the kick and the first couple of tackles after it. Widnes is a speed of line when chasing the kick downfield, vastly different to that from Castleford.
Do you know one of the differences, Phil, is that when Castleford kick the ball, they're kicking it on the front foot. When Widnes kick the ball, they're kicking it when they've not won the play of the ball leading up to it.
Castleford in possession. Here is Joe Westerman. Just inside the 40. A crowd of over 20,000 here this evening, or today really. We've had three games, of course, but this is the highlight. And here goes McGoldrick again. McGoldrick was looking for support. Nobody was there with him. Plays the ball. It's on the last. And it's a bit of a wild play, the ball from Castleford Tigers, but they're running it now, and then Brough fires that ball straight into touch. Well, that was a poor end to a good start, and the touch judge is on for an incident in back play.
It's probably because Dixon was taken out by Dodge. You see, in fact, not that hard, he went over the sideline.
Well, that was why there was nobody in support of Ryan McGoldrick then. That happened right underneath us here. We're high above the South Stand.
And the play will come all the way back after going out of the sideline on that side of the field. Here's the break. Speed from the action out by Henderson. Then McGoldrick makes the break. He's looking for his wingman. He's sat with the South Standers at the moment.
Terry Madison.
It was good work from the touch judge, but there were plenty of people reminding him in that South Stand.
It's do or die now for Widnes. A further score from Castleford, and I don't think they can come back, but they have to hang on. They've shown this season they can defend the line when needed.
Donlan now. Thumped to the ground by Webster and Noon. Westerman. Mark Smith putting the shoulder in for his side to stop the young second rower. Brough pops the ball up. Charles is thrown to the ground. Plays that ball. Thackeray with the kick or knock on. And offside, I think, as well for Widnes. It was the knock on by Blanch. There was a teammate in front of him who then went for the ball.
Well, he had to go on it, didn't he? almost forced to pick up the ball, concede the penalty, and hope they can survive now. Six more tackles on the line. The season comes down to potentially the next five plays.
Thackeray, Tomlin, trying to wrong-foot the defenders there, but Smith and James stood their ground. Here is Boyle now. Henderson.
They've got the numbers,
Charles. They have got the numbers out wide. And they are in with Shenton. Shenton with the try in the corner. And the relentless pressure from the Casper Tigers, as Terry Maddison says, just keep it going. Turn the screw. And they have done that. And young Michael Shenton with his 19th try of the season, just 21 years old. Much coveted by other Super League clubs when this Castleford side were relegated at the end of last season. He's stayed with them, and what a talent he is as well.
Well, it's pretty obvious. Well, it's Castleford in attack down this side. The ball you see ricocheting off Damien Blanch, a difficult one to take in. It's a knock-on, and James picks it up in an offside position. Castleford then followed up with a couple of straightforward carries to attract in the Widnes defence, offering the time and space for Shenton. Still great skill here from the Tigers. To get the ball to the men out wide is a lot easier than what it seems, and they got it there in time for him to score.
And Brough rubs salt in the wounds with an immaculate conversion from the touchline. 25 points to 4 now. The Casper Tigers lead, and that place in Super League is a little bit closer now.
Just a glorious ball on the outward angle, and it's Shenton who puts the ball down in the corner. And this is very, very dangerous for Widnes now. They need to show something in the next couple of minutes or Castleford will run away. Excellent coming away from their own line.
Donlan, the Castleford Tigers Player of the Year, was underneath that restart. He has been superb this season, Stuart Donlan. Terry Maddison looks just as anxious as he did at the outset, but he must feel a lot more comfortable now with his side 25 points to 4 ahead. And what a contrast this is. The last day of last season, he was in tatters with that defeat at Wakefield, consigning his side to National League One. Thackeray, a kick fielded by Damien Blanch. There's going to be some party at the Jungle tonight.
You talk about coaches being in tatters, mate. The Widnes coach, Steve McCauley, this is his fourth grand final he's been to. And he's been building for this game from last November, that he wanted to get to the grand final, stamp his authority on the game. And with the Widnes side that he's got on the pitch and that he's played all year, they're very, very good side, and they could win this game, could still get back into this game, but the longer it goes on, the more impossible it's going to be.
Moran with a little chip kick. Dodd is chasing it, but across is Donlan, and Dodd was high, and the penalty will go against the Widnes Vikings man.
Just a slightly deliberate
way for his head. The Tigers fans wanting him sent off. Well, I think that's a little bit optimistic, but it was wild from the winger.
So reckless, wasn't it? Good job he missed.
I know.
Duck just in time.
Was he not just straightening his fringe for him? He's only a winger, Phil. My God, what damage can he do?
He's rearranged the gel.
First move. So Castleford Tigers, after a shaky start to this second half, when they offered Widnes their try line, really. They've again dominated proceedings. Here is Brough. Thackeray it is, he's tackled by Cassidy. Now Brough. Now Westerman. Westerman. A tackle by Webster. And on that Widnes 20-metre line, Chris Charles.
Watch for the kick to the corner.
Or the 1 point.
Or the drop goal. Told you.
Brough again. 26 points to 4 now to the Widnes Vikings. and those Tiger supporters enjoying it, certainly 20,814, nearly 21,000, no doubt a National League Grand Finals record, magnificent attendance here. And it's been a great day with supporters from Bramley, Featherstone Lions, Featherstone Rovers, Oldham and now Castleford and the Widnes Vikings, and many neutrals as well here today.
There's lots of neutrals, Bill. I even saw somebody from Wigan, and as I walked past him, he said, "We're glutton for punishment coming here today."
Well, the sad thing, do you know the sad thing? I walked along the West Stand there, one or two discarded moustaches. You know how the Wigan fans were all wearing, just lying on the terracing, just a little symbolism of what Wigan went through. Those are all, I wonder if they've had their shaves now.
Yep, start all over again for the Wigan side. Boyle charging forward.
He's a big go-forward player, isn't he, Phil, the way he carries that ball.
Let's hope he's got a big future in the game. Young British player, Brough now puts it deep in the corner. The number of times he's been able to find the ball on the floor, in space, this time he finds the sideline. He's played well, but so have his teammates. Almost error-free, they've carried it forward. They came up with a few mistakes in the first half, but the rest of them kept their errors to a minimum.
Steve McCormack just wondering how his side are going to get back into this game from deep in their own half, which is, since that encouraging start to the second half, is largely where they've spent this game. Nanin. Not much breather for Steve McCormack. He's got Scotland to think about after this grand final.
You know, when you're playing a game and you're 23, you're in 23 minutes to go, you're 22 points behind. You can't worry about what it says on the scoreboard. What you've got to do is you've just got to get to the other end. You've got to either force the error, you've got to get the repeat sets. I'll try and force Castleford into doing things that they're not usual, they don't usually do, sorry. But Widnes just can't force the ball. They've just got to play through the set to get back up there, get back on the bike and come up with some tries.
Here is Webster. Higgins all over him. Makes the tackle. Moran. He tries a little bit of virtuoso, oh, and it just doesn't go his way. The bounce, unkind that time for Dennis Moran, just about summing up Widnes' fortunes. On another day, that would have sat up right in his hands.
You could say that, there'd be one or two chances really where you think Widnes would have been unlucky. But in general, Castleford have been far the better side. When you have to carry the ball forward, they've done it better than Widnes. When you have to tackle, they've been better at that as well. And simple case, sometimes the best team wins.
Chris Charles off to live the good life in France very soon.
Two movements! Wait, go.
Now then, Thackeray. What a good capture he was. Well, Danny Brough didn't know too much about that, but quickly put his skates on and gets away from two tacklers. Shouldn't have been allowed that. Now he's Kirk Dixon. Dixon down the sidelines, taking Gricks on, but Gricks sticks to his man and what's more, gets him into touch. Good defence. He's not throwing the towel in.
This is great play here, isn't it, from the fullback. Uses the sideline to help him as a tool, doesn't it? Knowing that if I can hold him up, there's only one way he can come. He's going to come back on the inside, and with the help of Nani, drags him over out of play. It's a pity that maybe Scott Gricks may end up on the losing side here today.
Time off, out. Stu Tiger,
Edinburgh. Gricks, an Irish international, one of five in this Widnes side who are in Andy Kelly's Ireland squad to play Russia in Carlow on October the 20th. Bricks, Dodd, Bezic, Blanche, Durant. So there's no rest for those five. And their coach Steve McCormack preparing the Scotland side for a massive game against the Welsh, the World Cup qualifier in Glasgow.
Over 10.
That's November the 4th, and winners of that, well, could be off to the World Cup, will be off to the World Cup.
Wait, go.
On the halfway line now. Moran, he tries it again, and this time there's a few on the same wavelength, but it's come up for the Castleford Tigers.
Come back, Dennis.
And the immaculate Donlan was there.
It's the only option available to them. They have to get their hands on the ball. And no matter how hard they hit in defence, they can't force a mistake from Castleford, whose ball control has been fantastic. Good enough to win you a grand final.
Westerman, Liapa, thumping collision with Wilkes, and Liapa withstood it.
That was a big shot, but again, Mark Liapa bounced off, as you see, a tremendous shot, but he bounces off and lands on his front, enabling Cass to attack again.
Another teasing kick and Grix is across well.
Done very well, Grix, in all aspects of the game for Widnes, but just going back to what Tez said about the last game and your mentality, you know, you've got months of pre-season to think about what your actual input to that last game was. And for the next 20 minutes or just less, you just want to get the things right. Make sure you're going into a pre-season with a positive frame of mind.
Widnes inside their own 20, looking for some inspiration. They trailed 26 points to 4 into the last quarter of the game. So there's still time for them to mount a heroic comeback. But it's just where the inspiration is going to come. Moran was maybe hoping for a 40-20. Instead, he's put it out on the full. And there's Widnes players with their hands on their hips and heads down.
You have to go for the high-risk players. Chip over, 40-20. You're in trouble, aren't you? 22 points behind, less than 20 minutes to go. You need some magic.
But they've been rubbing the lamp and the genie just won't appear for the Widnes Vikings.
Well, they didn't play well enough in the first half to give themselves a chance.
Oh, great step by Thackeray. Thackeray looked over his shoulder, there was nobody there.
Grix again with the tackle.
But that was another opportunity for the Cassaver Tigers. But that's now with Guttenbeel. Guttenbeel for Charles. Charles just managing to tackle him, was Jordan James keeping a hold of his ankle. Henderson for the line, and Henderson trying to twist over. He's just short, I think. Inches short. The Tigers captain, Westerman, again, he's just short. Or has he lost the ball? He's been given the try. And Joe Westerman caps a magnificent week for him. The National League One Young Player of the Year last Tuesday, and now a grand final try scorer, 11th of the season.
Well, I hope they were watching him do this for 10 years and more. This is Dennis Mann's attempt at the 40-20. Coming off criticism there, he needed some magic. They went for it, it didn't come up. But they've earned the right to crash over from a metre out because they've physically dominated the opponents for over an hour. And it hits the line. That's all you need to do, have the ball on the try line. The referee was well placed to see that he was there. And he gives Danny Brough a very easy conversion.
We are Super League is the chant from the Cassaver Tigers supporters. And I think that's on the button now. 32 points to 4 they lead.
Well, we've seen Sam Burgess in Bradford do some special things this year. He's going to have a massive future. But next year in Super League, we'll watch Joe Westerman. Still only a young player, and I'm not saying that players will peak until maybe their mid-20s or even after that, but Joe Westerman will offer some excitement to the Cassaver supporters next year. I've gone on about him several times this year.
I'm with you, Phil. A very, very exciting player, isn't he? But do you know that is a pet hit for all coaches, that sort of try. Diving over from dummy half, not showing any deception really. When you tight defenders, your A and B defenders should be really tight and be aware that someone's going to do that.
Second!
Liapa plays that ball, so Cassaver Tigers now firmly in command of this game and already thinking about life back in Super League. And many people believe that that's is where they belong. Brough, another booming kick from the boot of the Scottish international, and there's a good chase as well, bearing down on Gavin Dodd. Dodd brought to a halt.
It's amazing, isn't it, when you 32 points to 4 in front, and how much fresher you are in both defence and attack, and you've just seen the yellow jersey, they're chasing down the ball and really hurrying Widnes into coming up with a mistake.
And they do come up with a mistake. Paul Noon it is, who just fumbled that ball as he went to play it.
And the harder try now, the more they slip. Just slide the way out of this
inch. That's half an inch lifting your foot, an extra half an inch, and that comes from tiredness.
Brough. Dixon has come looping round from his wing to take that ball in midfield. Donlan. Luckton takes the hit from Wilkes, cannons off it and is then wrapped up by two more Widnes players on the 20-metre line. Here is Guttenbeel. Guttenbeel looking for another try, was he? Starting to motor then, the big Kiwi. Thackeray fires the ball out. Westerman could be in for a second here. He's just short of the try line, just stumbled. But his eyes must have lit up then when he saw the gap unfolding in front of him. They could be in at the corner. Clayton claiming that one. But I think it's going to be a decision for video ref Ian Smith. Clayton very close to the touchline there and the corner flag.
Well, the fatigue from the Vikings is starting to show with the gaps appearing. I don't think it does he score.
Oh, I think he might have done, you know.
Dodd offers him just enough to see the try line on the outside. The angle from behind won't convince us. From in front, it does look a try. Touch judge is in a great position.
That corner flag has moved, though. As the ball goes down, that corner flag has moved. Just there.
Yeah. Well, do you know, why do you need the corner flag? Because if the player is in the air and hits a corner flag, it's no try. But then, if you're in the air, there's out of the sideline without a corner flag. I don't see the purpose of a corner flag, you believe.
The try to Ryan Clayton, another member of the dream team selected in National League One, and it's a dream now for the Canterbury Tigers that's going to become a reality. Super League next season. And Ryan Clayton gets his ninth try of the season.
Well, we saw them on the short side. The last one was a dive over from a metre out. This one's a little harder. Just had to crash into the corner for Clayton. Good vision from Charles. Dodds just looking infield. Can't get across to push him over the side. I think Terry Matteson now. It's all relaxed. Big smiles all around for the Castleford Tigers.
Well, knowing Danny Brough, this the toughest kick he's faced all evening. He'll probably land this one. He's missed one or two in the first half. Missed two from comparatively easy positions. No, he's just dragged it inside. But now the Castleford Tigers ahead by 36 points to 4.
The issue with the corner flag and the corner pole, I think we need that on kicks. We need to determine whether a kick goes either side of the try line.
Well, you'd have a 40-20 flag then on that basis, Barry.
You do, but you don't have it on the pitch. This is a try, no doubt. And it's just quick thinking, and Ryan Clayton shows enough strength to get over.
Donlan. Now Liapa gets a big hit from Noon. And Widnes, well, they can look forward to another National League season. National League One, beaten grand finalists last year by Hull Kingston Rovers, and heading for another defeat here at a packed Headingley tonight. And one or two of the Widnes Vikings fans heading for the exits and the motorway. And the coach, Steve McCormack, well, he's experienced this before, but is there a sting in the tail here? Mark Smith intercepting that kick, but he needed somebody in support. Eventually, Toa Coe-Love arrives, but by that time, the Castleford Tigers had got back in defence.
Absolutely.
Now.
Absolutely. No Widnes players needed. Their enthusiasm Marcus. Levels are on the floor now.
Webster. Bezic. He's been a really consistent performer all season for the Widnes Vikings, Bob Bezic. Plays that ball. Webster.
Four. Line.
And the Widnes players, strangers to their own supporters at that end of the ground, but they've got something to cheer with Oliver Wilkes getting the try. And Wilkes try next to the posts, so it's formality for Mick Nannin, but it's too late, you feel, for the Widnes Vikings now.
Well, when the Vikings look back at this game, they'll think, every time we got near the line, we almost scored. Oh, we did score, it's just we didn't get there often enough. Here's the tempted chip over by Danny Brough, taken in by Mark Smith, but it's a tired Widnes side at this point in the game. Just over 10 minutes to go. They muster up the energy to get alongside Corey Love. Lovely play there from Mark Smith. Back reverse pass off the back, and Oliver Wilkes came with the determination. Only the brick wall over the dead ball line would stop him going through.
Nanin has, as expected, thumped that one between the posts. So 36 points to 10, the scoreline. And Oliver Wilkes, a try score against Castleford in the Northern Rail semi-final victory that Widnes had earlier in the season, on the scoreboard again. 15th try of the season. But he knows, the look there said it all, you know. And too late.
It was a clever play by Ollie Wilkes there. He used the goalpost there so the Cast defenders couldn't get to him. You see Paul Sculthorpe doing it all the time in Super League, and Ollie Wilkes learns a lesson from him there.
And here he is once more. Thunderous run from Wilkes, and he gets away from Guttenbeel, which is probably a good idea, and gets over the 20-metre line.
More square.
Goodness, if they're going to just make this an interesting contest in the last 10 minutes, need another try on the scoreboards. Might just cause a few palpitations for the Castleford Tigers supporters.
I really do think, Bill, like, early on in the season, Widnes won both the games against Castleford, who were really the dominant side, but as they finished off Castleford, have won the last two games. But I think that the player who's had the most influence on these results is Anthony Thackeray. He had so much to the Cast attack and Cast defence. He's just a really outstanding player, and he's been great. He's been a great acquisition this year for Castleford.
Kick deep, and Donlan fields it for the Castleford Tigers. Noon there with the tackle.
First! And wait.
There is Thackeray.
Go.
Is he your one to watch then for next year in Super League, Terry?
He definitely is. As a young kid, mate, I think the way he bosses his forwards around the pitch and the way all he keeps doing, he plays a simple game plan where he just turns the big lads in, then hits the runner and then takes them on himself. You never know what he's going to do. He's got three big players.
I think there's a few, Phil. I think this kid goes well, as we've already talked about Weston, and he goes all right, so future's looking good, youth-wise, for Castleford. I'm sure there's a couple of others who haven't progressed just yet, but, you know, Castleford as an area produces a lot of players.
Richard Owen, yes, of course, hasn't been a part of this Castleford side in the closing weeks of the season because of a hamstring injury. Another teenager still on par with Westerman.
Very young, yes. He's got plenty of time on his side.
Cass, hold the 10!
And it'll be interesting to see how Terry Madison's recruiting goes. Surrender! In preparation for next Super League season. Madison with some great contacts from his Brisbane days, I'm sure.
I think the thing you've learned from looking at Hulkingston Rovers this year is perhaps they're given last pick because they come into Super League last.
Well,
but there's a lot of trade taking place between the season. Number of players coming in and moving out as the season progresses.
It's interesting you say that, because in the programme for this Grand Finals day, there is actually a guide from Justin Morgan to preparing for life in Super League. Tips from the top.
Try and get up.
You have to work very hard, don't you? If you're the last team up, you're given last pick of the players.
Tonlan underneath that one, safe as houses.
It's under a lot of pressure from Gavin Dodd. He knew the kick was coming.
Second.
And just put a lot of pressure on Stuart Daniel. Not for 1 second did he take his eye off the ball.
Challenge Cup finalists last year with the Huddersfield Giants, Stuart Donlan, a losing experience that day at Twickenham when they were thumped by St Helens, but this is a much more pleasurable occasion for the Castleford Tigers fullback. Here's his opposite number, Scott Grix, who again has been an outstanding performer in that position.
What about that for a pressure-relieving kicker? It was Danny Brough at acting halfback, just kicked the ball probably about 60 metres. Grix was out of position, but he had to run back, get it, made 10 metres, and the Castleford line of defence was right up there again. They've done all the little things really, really well today.
On the 40-metre line now, the Widnes Vikings. Summers, quick hands straight into the hands of the opposition, and Wainwright was almost away there.
And they've got to look to force that pass, haven't they? And the game's well and truly beyond them now, but there's still going to be chances now and trying to come up with a score.
Higgins.
Again, Tez, you keep going back to it, that last game, you want to give the fans something to remember, something so they can hold their head up.
Thackeray is tackled 10 metres out, almost through there, but Summers got a hold of him. Now Brough across the field, Guttenbeel will wrap it up with a try under the post, the second try for Aaron Guttenbeel. And Terry Madison can celebrate now with Ryan McGoldrick and Mark Liapa. And how he has rewarded his coach Aaron Guttenbeel. Two tries, eight for the season.
Well, the Tigers have set the example for both Centellins and the Leeds Rhinos. It's about simplicity and control in the game, and they've had that for the majority of this match. Eventually, that pays off, and they then convert the dominance into points. Again, another great try, hitting back. The Widnes defence staggered. They're holding it at this point in the match, and Guttenbeel knows to run into one of them, reach out again with that right hand around the ball, and he knows now it's party time tonight.
Oh, how it has changed for Terry Maddison, that sinking feeling last season, elation this time. Brough bumps that one high into the new stand here, just checks it's reached the top road. 42-10 the scoreline. The Tiger Army is on the march towards Super League, and Aaron Guttenbeel with his second try of the game, 2002. A losing grand finalist with the New Zealand Warriors against the Roosters. Well, this time he's going to be a grand final winner. Griggs with the restart. Boyle underneath it. Just 4 minutes to go now, and Boyle comes charging back. And poor Steve McCormack. That sinking feeling again for him. Four in a row. Well, four defeats, I should say.
There's no harder working coach in this division than Steve McCormack. It's a big call, but he's been there for the... This is his fourth grand final, and together he knows, and he does extra work constantly because the last 3 occasions he's got there, he's lost, so he wants to always improve, and I've got to feel really sorry for him as I know the lad like I do.
You do, and Thackeray taking exception to that tackle from Lee Durant. You know, given what's been at stake between these two sides today, and people's livelihoods are on the line here. And that's the first bit of real nastiness we've seen, I think, and a bit of reaction. And that sums it up for the Viking supporters. A tearful experience. And a painful one. Calcifer Tigers with an opportunity to round this one off in style. 3 minutes to go, they're ahead by 42 points to 10. Boyle, tackled by Summers and Cassidy. Is this the swan song for Mick Cassidy after a long and illustrious career, 34 years of age?
He had signed a contract to play in Super League next year. I don't know whether he's going to take up the option to play in National League, but it'll be a big loss to Widnes if he doesn't play.
Boyle. Brough, he'll hoist the kick, putting Damien Blanche under pressure, and Blanche takes it well. The Widnes Vikings have never really dominated at any phase of this game. They've had moments or periods in the game when they've got a grip, certainly in the first half.
You get in front in a big game, tend to stay there, don't you? Things are going right, your confidence grows, the pressure on the opposition grows, and you can just, if you continue like Castleman have shown today, to maintain that concentration, you just go on to win the match.
Widnes' best spell was probably the last 10 minutes of the first half, where they seemed to get back into the game, the players running to the right hold, but it's just not to be tonight. 42 points to 10, they're going to be very disappointed, there's a bunch of players. But you've got to credit Castleford, haven't you?
Heaviest defeat of the season for the Widnes Vikings. What a time to come up with a performance like that. Moran trying until the end with all his little tricks. And this time it's going to get back to him eventually. But then he gets the ball to Mark Smith, and Smith darting through the middle. And that will be the turnover. The tackle was completed, says Phil Bentham.
Wait till it, lads.
Steve McCormack. Another painful experience for the likeable Widnes Vikings coach, and consolation from his opposite number, Terry Maddison.
And they say that what doesn't kill you only makes you stronger.
Crikey, he's going to be multi-strong now, isn't he?
Well, strength of Samson eventually. Let's hope that in his coaching career, he looks back on this and thinks that it helped to make me what I am as time goes on. Still only a very young man in coaching terms.
Clayton, here is Donlan. The clock ticking down now. Terry Maddison celebrating. I just can't get the vision of him at the end of last season, virtually in tears as his side was relegated, and this time he's all smiles. What a contrast for him and for this club. And of course the new ground that Castleford Tigers hoping will come on stream very soon, as the ball goes out of play and Terry Maddison and his team can celebrate. They can celebrate Super League next season. And the Tigers players salute their supporters. And there is Terry Maddison. He's led this side back to Super League at the first attempt. A long, hard season has finished with the Widnes Vikings on their knees. And Castleford Tigers, as Alan Guttenbeel demonstrates, number one. They finished top of the table and they've proved their superiority here this evening. They have emphatically beaten the Widnes Vikings by 42 points to 10. Terry Maddison must be thrilled at the turnaround for this club. He's now with Ben.
Terry, your face looks a world of difference from what it was last year. How are you feeling?
Oh, I feel on top of the world, you know. You can put the last 12 months to bed now, and there's never a day's gone by I've stopped thinking about that last day. And I feel for Steve McCormack now, because he's where I was last year, and it's not a nice place to be. I'm grateful for the boys, but they were outstanding today and they've been outstanding all year, and I'm just pleased that we can move on.
You had to think long and hard about even staying at Castleford. How close were you to leaving the club?
I've got no idea, to be honest, because, you know, with my family to come up here and start a new life, and then what happened 12 months ago is the most devastating thing that I've been through. And those people over there, you know, they make it all worthwhile, the fans. I'd just like to thank my wife for sticking by me through this time. All those players, they're unbelievable.
Are you ready for Super League this time?
We're going to be. We're way ahead of where we were last time, and we can bring these kids through, you know. The kids we've got coming through in our area, you know, deserve to play Super League. And again, you know, that's where we're going to put our faith, in the juniors.
Well done, Terry. Enjoy the deserved celebrations.
Right, thanks to Sky, and thanks to Witness, everyone. Thank you.
Well, what a contrast. What a contrast to 12 months ago when Terry Maddison was in as much despair as these Widnes players must be right now. Yet again, they've knocked on the Super League door, Widnes, and yet again it's been slammed firmly shut in their faces. Poor old Steve McCormack, that's four grand finals in a succession now that he has lost. Two with Whitehaven, two with Widnes. He doesn't seem to have the magic to win a grand final. But Castleford, well, I'll tell you what, the towns of Castleford and Featherstone will be very busy tonight, because there is plenty to celebrate, and there is for this fellow. Danny Brough leaves the Castleford scene as man of the match in this Cooperative National League One grand final. He'll take that trophy home with him and all the way to Wakefield, because he was back in Super League before this game got going. Castleford weren't, but now they are. So well done to Danny Brough, well done to the Castleford Tigers, and bad luck to poor old Widnes. These supporters had a dreadful time of it last year. Mick Nannin, he has now also lost four grand finals now. Phil Bentham and the match officials taking their mementos of the big day. And that's Bob Bezic just waving goodbye to the supporters. And you have to wonder how many of these Widnes players will be in Widnes colours next year. There are one or two, obviously, where age is catching up with them. Old Father Time has arrived. But you also have to wonder about how many will be still with the club at the start of next season. For Castleford, though, it's all onward and upward. Barry and Terry are here in the studio with me. It was we talked about a comprehensive defeat by Featherstone of Oldham in the National League Two Grand Final, Barry. This was a dismantling of Widnes.
It was, and I talked about the chess game and being patient. I thought Widnes would have been far more patient than they actually showed. But again, you know, I used the phrase at the start of the Oldham Featherstone, play the game and not the occasion. I think Widnes were trying to score on every given chance, and that's the problem with having so many game breakers and game winners in one team. Castleford are a lot more rounded as a set of individuals. They come together and they unify very, very well.
You two obviously will know a lot of the Widnes players who are on their way up here for these losers' medals again. Yeah. Now. You were with them 12 months ago in the heat of the battle. They won't take it well, Terry.
No, they won't. And probably, Eddie, that was the darkest day of my professional career. Last year, when we failed to get back into Super League, I was in the team that was relegated, and I wanted to play on that year to get back up into Super League. But I really do feel sorry for that man there on the screen, Steve McCormick. What a hard-working guy, and a lad who wears his hat on his sleeve, really. And it's going to be interesting to see if Widnes can keep hold of a lot of these key players, because I personally feel that a lot of them will be going elsewhere.
Do you?
I really do, mate. The buzz in the town already is that the club's going to go part-time next year. They're going to put everything into going for the franchise in 2009. But they still have to do the right things off the pitch to get into that franchise position, because you've got Castleford around there, you've got Salford around there, you've got the Welsh team around there. There's going to be a lot of decent teams applying for the franchise.
Well, one team will be applying for a franchise from the strength of being in the 2008 Super League, and it's the Castleford Tigers who have won here and made their mark on National League One this season. Arwen Guttenbeel, hasn't he done well for them?
That's a nice touch.
He also, by the way, had to decide to come over and play National League after he'd been signed up for Super League in 2007.
And that's a nice touch, that the players will have said to him, listen, mate, you get up there, you get your medal first. You know, going back to my career, when we were at Elland Road and the World Club Challenge, the lads sent me up first, and it meant a lot to me. Arwen Guttenbeel would have added a lot of strength of character when he joined that club, and certainly when we talk about being in big games, Arwen Guttenbeel has been in everything. And being assistant coach and being a player assistant coach is a very, very tough thing to do.
It is indeed, but they obviously think a lot of him. And this way, by the looks of things, as opposed to the Featherston skipper who was left at the back of the field and they gave the cup to somebody else.
It was Tonks, weren't it? He couldn't wait, could he?
Absolutely. It looks like it's going to go to Henderson, Andrew Henderson.
He's going to get it. And what a big game he's had for him. Like, there was a battle of hookers, both Mark Smith and both Henderson were exceptional today, but just give him that desire to win around that middle of the pitch, and Widnes targeted him.
There you go. Andrew Henderson raises the trophy. Castleford Tigers are back in Super League after a 12-month absence. And I can't help remembering the night for all of the Tigers fans, for this fellow in particular. He had tears in his eyes at Wakefield last year when they went down. He believed that he probably wouldn't be back this year. It would be the end of the line, that some of the players and the coaching staff would have to go elsewhere and find a living. Well, look what he's achieved in the past 12 months. You have to fear for Steve McCormack, though, don't you? It's the fourth defeat in a grand final. Here he is with Rod.
Steve, sympathy isn't a word that's often used in professional sport, but I think even the most hardened Castleford fans would feel some for you tonight after four straight defeats in a grand final. How are you feeling?
Well, it's not about me, it's about the club, isn't it? All credit to Castleford, they were superb. They deserve it. You know, it takes a good team to win a grand final. From our point of view, I'm proud for what the lads have achieved this season. Just a shame we couldn't have done it in the final.
Were there moments just after half-time when you thought you might get back into it, when you almost scored and almost got it back to 5 or 6 points?
Yes, almost, isn't it? That's what finals are all about. You take your chances, or when you get your chances, you've got to take them, and Castleford were clinical, we weren't.
Terry and Barry have been saying how hard, and they know, having worked with you, how hard you've been working over the last couple of years. What will happen to Widnes now, do you think?
Well, we don't know, do we? It's just a matter of getting over this and obviously try and lick our wounds, and you know, some big decisions are going to have to be made by the club, and you know, both on and off the field.
Thanks for speaking to us, Steve. Really appreciate it.
Okay.
He's a disappointed man, Steve McCormack. I think the big difference, Terry, between Castleford and Widnes throughout the season and tonight, you look down the Castleford list, you've got Anthony Thackeray, you've got Joe Westerman, you've got Ryan Boyle. For Widnes, you've got Mick Nannin, you've got Dennis Moran, you've got Mick Cassidy, with the very best will in the world, players who are coming to the end of their careers.
But as well, yes, you have, Eddie, but You've got players who've been there and done it. Mick Nanning's been to four grand finals. He's had the experience of knowing what's at stake to get into it. Mick Cassidy leads by example constantly, all the time, but just saw there, Steve McCoy. It doesn't make any excuses for losing today.
No.
It just says Castleford were by far the better side, which they were, and that is why I've got total respect for Laddin. He's signed a contract for next year, whether it be Super League or National League, at Widnes, so you'll see him again.
Well, Danny Brough was the man of the match. There he is. He's with Rod now.
Danny, his dream games go. Is that just about the perfect game you've ever had?
Yeah, without a shadow of a doubt, you know. Had a lot of pressure on me today, people saying I want to hear for Castleford. But, you know, that's me. I just turn up, do my job. I'll 100% Castleford till 31st of November, and I've done what people didn't think I'd do.
You know how much it means to the club. Just sum it up for us about getting straight back to Super League.
Oh, mate, I think you can see that in itself. You just look behind us. There's that many people here from Castleford who needed big-time rugby, and they've got that now.
As you said, you're going to Wakefield for next season now. You're going to miss Castleford?
Yeah, of course I miss Castleford. It's been a part of my life for a year and a half now. But, you know, I have to move on, same as everybody else, and hopefully I can do a job for Wakefield next year.
Well done, Danny.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Danny Brough, a Challenge Cup winner with Hull in 2005, a Grand Final winner with Castleford 2007, and a Super League player with Wakefield in 2008. And, of course, back and reunited with his former coach at Hull, John Keir, next year. But looking at the match as it was played out today, I must say that Castleford Tigers, Hull Kingston Rovers were formidable and were impressive against Widnes 12 months ago. Castleford Tigers look as good, if not better, to me. And 2008 would be very interesting from their point of view. Well, more action across four Sky Sports channels tonight. Spanish football, Barcelona, Atletico Madrid now, Sky Sports 1. Live Horse of the Year show next on Sky Sports 2 and HD2. Live NFL, Washington against Detroit is over on Sky Sports 3. And Golf Night is next here on Sky Sports Extra. Well, we're just about finished for 2007 domestically, but not quite. We have the small matter of the Super League Grand Final, and that will be settled on Saturday night. St Helens against Leeds from Old Trafford live, 5:30, Sky Sports 1 and Sky Sports HD 1, channel 408. And these two will be telling you the best 10 moments of Grand Final history on Friday night. Join them for that. Join us at Old Trafford on Saturday. Bye-bye.
Scored for Featherston Rovers. Wayne McHugh is chasing this. Two for Wayne McHugh. It's Featherston Rovers who return to the second tier of rugby league.
This could be a try. Wayne Wright will score. Men out to the right, McGoldrick is one of them, McGoldrick is over for the try! Oh, what an inspirational try from Alan Guttenfield! They can celebrate Super League next season.
More sport, news and views...